You're back in an All-Ireland final. hoping to make two in a row.
It's brilliant. Like, we're absolutely chuffed. We were all so nervous coming in today because we knew, like, Galway, we played them twice this year already, and like, they first time they beat us, second time we probably stole it from them. So absolutely delighted to finally, I think semi-finals are nearly harder than finals because you're not quite at the final yet, so we were definitely nervy coming into the match, but absolutely thrilled.
Absolutely. I was at that league semi-final in Dublin, or Galway put up a huge performance against you. You grinded it out, but today you made no mistake.
Yeah, I think our work rate was something that we were really proud of today. From the get-go, we knew that, as Finno said, that we were going up against a really tough team. Like, their forwards are excellent and can take scores from anyway. So we really wanted to protect the D, and I think that our work rate from the goalie all the way up was kind of got us over the line.
I think Dublin definitely had the homework done today on Galway. The way you pressed them up the field, and your defensive play was outstanding, especially in the first half. Your tackling, your rate of tackling, and your transition play, it was excellent.
I think, credit to our management team, they really do eat, breathe and sleep football. They don't leave any stone unturned, so they had us well prepared coming into the match. And when you're coming into a game and they've provided you with as much information as they possibly can, you do really feel that extra bit of confidence coming into a game, because you feel like you've prepared as well as you possibly can. So and the forwards, as you said, they worked really, really hard, so made the backs' jobs a little bit easier when the pressure was coming up from further up the pitch. So it's great.
Now, while the first half was a roundup performance, it was an excellent performance, there was periods in the second half where Dublin dipped out again, and that's something to work on going into the final.
Yeah, I think maybe we lost a bit of concentration, and that's, as you said, that's something that we're going to focus on kind of the whole 60 minutes, from the very get-go. Just keep pushing hard, pressing up, because, come to the final, I think that we lost our concentration, they got a goal in, so that's something that we'll definitely work on for the final.
It's probably not a bad thing to have something like that in the back of your head, that you need to push on in the next couple of weeks and to build up to the final.
Yeah, I think every team, no team is the complete team. We always have stuff to learn, for every time we go out to the training pitch, we are learning. Mick is great, and he definitely instills in us that we always have stuff to improve on. And as you said, we did dip the intensity in the second half, and that is brilliant to have stuff to work on going forward. We have Cork in the final, and there's great history between ourselves and Cork, so really, really looking forward to that. So great to get another shot of them again.
And even just for anyone to come out and give support, it's a really good day to showcase ladies' gaelic football for anyone, boys, girls that are interested in men and women. It's a really good occasion, and I think we're honoured to get there again, and it'd be great to get a massive crowd out to support the Dubs.
I have to agree with you. I was there last year. I was there as a spectator last year in the crowd. It was an unbelievable day out, and I would agree that anyone that hasn't been there should be there.
But thank you.
Maybe not supporting the Dubs, but supporting everyone.
Well,
I suppose, moving on from that, we were up in the one thing I noticed today, we were up in the media box today. The media box was packed. All the main news streams in Ireland were there, covering the game, live broadcast on RTE, and TG Cahir, obviously. And, that's massive. The coverage of ladies football is just getting better and better every year. It's unbelievable. It's brilliant.
So, over the years, we've seen how it's grown in popularity, but obviously there still can be more improvements, but TG Cahir are absolutely fantastic. They've been there for the last 10, 11 years, and without them, the sport would not have gotten the exposure that it has gotten. So fair play to them for sticking with us from the very, very start, and that's great that everyone was here today, and hopefully they'll all be out of the final as well, supporting.
Absolutely, and look, there was a great crowd here today too for all the matches, and it's brilliant to keep it going. I suppose Cork in the final, as you said, there's history there. There's, it'll be a great build-up for yourselves. What will it be like in the Dublin camp for the next couple of weeks? You've been there before. What will you be doing? What will be the typical build-up for the next few weeks?
I think it'll be the same as any other game. I know it's a very cliche thing to say that. It's every game, you take one at a step at a time, and that's what we'll be doing. The lads will be doing their homework on them. They'll be feeding us the information, and we'll just be working as hard as we can to make sure we get over the line.
It's a white line, We'll have, come one day, it's going to be everyone fighting for positions and trying to get a jersey on the day. Our management team, as they did for today, are going to put no stone unturned against the players to keep pushing on and, just making sure we're prepared as possible for the final.
Well, look, enjoy the build-up.
Thank you.
The very best of luck in the game. I, for one, am really looking forward to the final. As I said earlier, I think two best teams are in the final. I think it's going to be a great final and a great day for ladies football. So.